Hi everybody, today I'm in Darlinghurst and I'm here to introduce one of our new customers. It's called Sandoitchi, and today it's going to be special. I have a Kobe beef, which we are selling online nearly $600 per kilo, and this restaurant is famous for the katsu sando, all the variety of the different katsu sando, and we will try to make up something unique, and it's gonna be Sydney's most expensive Wagyu Katsu Sando. Okay, let's go inside and find out. Bhass-san, and he's the owner of Sandoitchi, and for today, can you tell us a little bit about your restaurant? How long have you been running this restaurant for, and what the inspiration of behind it, and also sure. I want to know big why you started this restaurant and the concept.
Oh yeah, sure. We are Sandoitchi Cafe, which is based on the corner of the Crown Street and Oxford Street.
Yeah.
So we've been here 3 years already. Yeah. So what we do, I'll be serving a Japanese style sandwich with the coffee from the single. So okay. Our instruction is just pretty simple for me. I like street vendor. I like street food. So this cafe based on the street vendor flavor and textures, and also cuisine of the Japanese plus Thai, which is my background. But if people talking about Sandoitchi Cafe, they're talking about the pork as a sandwich, which is untraditional way with a Thai style marinade and with some American cheese and pickled carrots and solid cucumber. And also our prawns, which is prawn katsu sando with a sweet corn and yuzumaye, also really popular too.
Why you started more like a focus on the Japanese food?
Yeah, so as my background, I grew up in Thai, but I have really strong belief in the Japanese culture. I studied Japanese for quite some time, and I also learned to the Japanese culture. So when I grew up and I start cooking, Thai and Japanese both cuisine is that I'm learning from. So because of that, when I try to get Japanese cuisine, which is based on the street vendor and the Thai street food, and combine together and create my own style of cooking. And then my partner and I, we build this together and we both love Japanese food.
And today, Kobe beef, and this piece, 4.4 kilos. This piece is gonna be $2,500 per piece. So if you go to the restaurant, probably you have to pay nearly twice more. You know, that's how expensive this piece is, and for the beef, okay? And today, Bhass will make a Wagyu Katsu Sando with this Kobe beef in sandwich style, okay?
So today, I'm going to show you how to cook Kobe Wagyu Katsu Sando. So it's going to base on the thick cut white bread, plus the kombu butter and fish sauce. Ready? Let's go, let's jump in.
All right, let's go. this is it. It's all done. So look, this is the most expensive Wagyu Katsu Sando. If you go to restaurants, this one is going to be over $200. That means one piece, cutting four pieces, one piece is going to be over $50. And about he's thinking about Kobe beef on his menu, I hope.
Oh, sure.
Anyway, okay, so let's try this and yeah, find out. It's good. Really thick. Because I asked you how thick that Kobe beef should be cut. It's really good. I saw the really coarse panko breadcrumbs. That's really good because most of the Wagyu Katsu Sando, whatever the sando, normally they use really, you know, small. Yeah, but your one's really coarse. It's more like a real Japanese style.
Thank you.
I like it.
Thank you very much. Rather than, you know, I'm just honored to be able to cook this Kobe with you. But I just, it's a small fish in the ocean, you know. Thanks again.
Yeah, yeah, you should try it. This is the different. I know you are using Wagyu tenderloins for your Wagyu Katsu Sando. It is different because tenderloin is less marbled but very tender. But this is really highly marbled, so it is different. And as I said before, I have a few of our very loyal customers. Her name is Fiona. And she's really active on the social media, especially Instagram. And she's going to be a guinea pig for Wagyu Katsu Sando tonight. And also, she's going to cook interesting recipe for us. And please follow us, okay? And Fiona, please try one big, $50.
Well, so I'm holding a $50 piece of Sando right now, so I'm going to try this. I'm really excited. It's quite buttery and rich in flavor, and it literally just melts in your mouth. It's so beautiful. And I do like how the bread is slightly toasted, so it gives it a bit of texture as well. And the kombu butter, it's brilliant.
Yeah,
so
it is very unique. Never heard of a kombu butter.
It's delicious.
So, guys, this is the most expensive Wagyu Katsu Sando. Hopefully, you will try one day. People can try authentic Kobe beef Wagyu Katsu Sando. And I have another customer. His name is Marcelo.
Hi, everyone.
And I'm going to reveal who he is. He's a the person I closely work together for this video content, creating this video content. And for this time, he asked me, Mr. Osawa, I really want to, you know, try a piece of Kobe beef Wagyu Katsu Sando. That's why I just pretend he's one of our customers, but actually he's not. But
I begged and begged. I said, can I pretend to be a customer for this episode? I have to try Wagyu Katsu Sando with the Kobe beef. I've had katsu sando before, but with the Kobe beef, never. So I'm super excited for today.
Yeah. So that's why, you know, I'm taking he's taking advantage of who he is. So that's why, you know, I give you the $50 piece of Wagyu Katsu Sando only this time.
Yeah, just this once. All right, I've been waiting long enough. I'm going to try this. Oh wow, look at the marble. That's crazy. Mm. Weird thing to talk about with such an expensive sandwich, but the mustard, really nice. So, well done, bud.
Thanks, buddy.
Very good. But, is that good enough for me?
So good.
Thank you.
name is Bhass. I'm a chef and founder of Sandoitchi Cafe. We are in the Oxford Street at the corner of Cross Street in Darlinghurst. We are serving a Japanese style of sandwich and we are open 7 days a week. If you guys ever heard of us, please come and check it out. And if you guys also like to have Kobe Katsu Sando, please let us know. We can organize something for you. Thank you.
Okay, so today we are having an amazing Wagyu Katsu Sando, and today I pick 2 points. The reasons I highly recommend you should come over. It's not a big restaurant, but menu is amazing. You can choose so many different, more like Japanese style dishes. Of course, you should try Katsu Sando. Katsu Sando means pork cutlet deep fried. That's the most popular ones. In the morning or daytime, you are really interested in to come over and you feel a little bit peckish, you try something small. Why don't you try, it's called egg sando, and it's really Japanese style, really fluffy. Also, they have a donburi style, all the different kind of dishes, you should try it. I'm really interested to try one day, it's called a miso eggplant sando. Because even if you are vegetarian, you can try authentic Japanese style sandwich. Like I asked the Bhass to pack the strawberry sando, it comes like this. It looks like if you've been to Japan, go to like a convenience store. Looks like a shortcake, we call it shortcake. Please check out our YouTube channel and also please subscribe it and also check our website and we create interesting items all the time and also check our social media, okay? Thank you for watching. See you soon.